While we are drawing, we may need to check if the dimensions we specified are correct. To get a quick view of the dimensions within my drawing, I can click on the arrow of the Measure tool, which can be found in the Home ribbon, and activate the Quick Measure tool. Notice that this tool displays the dimensions, distances, and angles dynamically as I move my cursor over and between objects. I will press Escape to deactivate the tool and reopen the list with the measuring options to show you the next one, which is the distance option. I can measure the length of a line by clicking on the first endpoint and then the other. In this example, the length of the line I measured is 5.2. Notice that the tool does not deactivate. On the contrary, a list with all the measuring options appears, so I can continue measuring. I will select the distance option again, and I will proceed to measure the distance between the middle chair and the sofa. Once I am sure that those distances are correct, I will select the radius option and click on the inner wall's polyline arc. Automatically, the radius and diameter of the arc are being displayed. Naturally, with this option, I can also measure the radius and diameter of a circle or an arc. At this point, I am going to select the angle option and I will click on the sloped side of the slab and then on the horizontal side. The angle between the two lines is 120 degrees. I can either select the next option or press Escape to deactivate the measuring tool. I should mention that all these options we previously selected from the list can be found in the list of the Measure button too. I will select the Area option to measure the area of the kitchen, the living room, and the office. To measure the area, I need to trace the perimeter of the object or the room whose area I wish to measure. I will start by clicking on the lower right endpoint of the kitchen's wall, and then I will click on the lower left endpoint. Next, I will click on the endpoint right before the arc. At this point, I have to click on the arc option in the command line in order to be able to trace the arc of the wall. So I will select the arc option, and then I will click on the other endpoint of the arc. Now, as you can see, I have to return to the line option again before I continue tracing, so I will click on the line option from the command line. I will click on the rest of the endpoints until I reach the first point I clicked. Once I am done tracing the perimeter of the area, I will press Enter and both the area and the perimeter are being displayed. But what happens if I wish to measure the area of two rooms that are not next to each other? Let's say I wish to measure the area of the bathroom and the office. In this case, I will select the Area option from the list, and before I start defining the corner points, I will select the Add Area option from the command line. I will define the corner points of the bathroom's perimeter and press Enter. Although the bathroom's area and perimeter are being displayed, I can still add areas. So I will also trace the perimeter of the office. Once I press Enter again, notice that below the office's area and perimeter, the total area is displayed. Now, imagine that I wish to measure the area of the kitchen and the living room, and then I want to remove the area of the kitchen. To do that, I will press Enter one more time, so the list with all the measuring options will appear again. I will select the Area option once more. If I intend to subtract areas, I have to select the Add Area option before I start measuring. Now all I need to do is trace the perimeter of those two rooms, and once I'm done with specifying carefully all the corner points, I will press Enter. Then, I will select the Subtract Area option from the command line and I will trace the kitchen's perimeter. I will start by clicking on the lower left corner then on the lower right corner, and then on the upper right corner. Once I reach the left side, I will use the perpendicular snap to define the last corner. I will press Enter, and now the area and the perimeter of the subtracted area, namely the kitchen, appear first. The total area of the two rooms also appears below. Last but not least, I will show you how you can calculate the volume of an object. I will press Enter one more time to select the volume option. In this example, I will calculate the volume of the wardrobe in the bedroom. To calculate the volume, I need to trace the perimeter of the object. Alternatively, I can select the object option from the command line and select the polyline that represents the wardrobe. Once I select the object, I have to specify the height of the object. I will type the number 1.76 and then press Enter. The volume was calculated and it is about 5.45 cubic meters. When I no longer wish to measure anything else, I can press Escape or select the Exit option to deactivate the command.